Hi, I'm Jim Booker with HorizonRC.com. Today I've got John Redman with me, and John, as you know, is the product developer for the E-flite Nieuport 17 that we've got here today. Nieuport's a really cool little airplane, flies real well indoors or in a very calm outdoor situation. People have been putting it together, and John's got some helpful hints, and he's going to do us a little favor by doing a how-to for us. John, what are you up to today? I understand you want to show people some easy ways to finish up their Nieuport here.
Basically, Jim, what we'd like to do is show them how the airplane should look and what to look for while they're rigging it. A very important part of the Nieuport is to have the dihedral in the wings.
Yep.
Okay. That'll enable the airplane to turn with rudder only and turn very well and fly well. If you have too much dihedral, you're stressing the wings too far into the point to where they could fail in a light wind if you fly outside and such. And then if you don't have enough, you'll find it'll turn, but it'll take a very long time to get it back because it has to swing the nose instead of working off the balancing of the wing and the aerodynamics.
Okay, so I get it. So actually the rigging is a functional part of this airplane then?
Very functional. You'll find some people have said our wings, the foam we use is not very strong and they want carbon reinforcement and such. And we've looked at that. To do that would raise the price up pretty dramatically in this price class model. And if you rig it as we say and fly it as it's intended and not as a 3D aerobatic machine, it'll hold up all day long.
No 3D?
No 3D on this one.
Come on. Oh, well. Hey, you know, there's a huge bunch of flyers out there that don't fly 3D and they're looking for these kind of airplanes.
I think they are too.
So. I love them, of course. Okay, well, where do we go? Where do we start?
Well, what I've done is I have basically set the aircraft up as you would want it set up. Once you have the rigging installed, but none of the rigging is glued in. We are going to glue the rigging at each and every point where it rolls through the inner plane struts to secure it once it's fully complete.
Okay.
So you run the rigging through as per the instruction manual. It seems like everyone understands that in the manual real well. Okay. But what can happen when you start gluing it, if you're not careful, is one, you can get too much dihedral, or two, you can actually build a slight bow or twist and warp into the wings, which will cause the plane to not fly straight. Mm-hmm. And what we're looking for here is almost some old free flight talents when you rig it out to ensure the wings aren't warped. So what we're going to do is I'm going to explain to the gentlemen out there and all our modelers of what parts of the wing to look at from a parallax standpoint in front of the airplane to see the warps and the twist. Mm-hmm. And we've done a little on RC groups initially. And guys came back and showed some pictures, and they were nailing it. So this is just going to be out there for everyone else and such. So what we have done is you can see I have taped the landing gear in place, and I have set our Pacer zip kicker cans, which I think are also shown in the manual. It's 5 5/8. You can make blocks of wood, foam, whatever you like. We just happen to have some of these cans initially, and that's how we found they worked. The big key is when the aircraft is taped and secured in place, it needs to be in a level status, like a flight status.
Right.
You don't want the tail touching the ground. If you do, you're going to have way too much dihedral.
I see.
Okay, so that's step one for the guys, is they got this and such. Now, as they sit down and they look, what they're looking for is you want to stand back about 6 to 8 feet from the airplane, get your eyes down to where they are pretty much in line with the leading edge of the top wing. From there, you look to each side, looking down the leading edge, making sure both leading edges are about identical, correct. But now you want to see where the trailing edge falls on each side to the leading edge. And if you happen to have one that falls more than the other, that is showing you a warp. And we can't have that.
Okay.
To fix that, it's not hard. You'll sit down, airplane's taped in place. You sit down and you can actually just move the wings fore and aft slightly. As you can see, the wings are moving.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. When you move that one forward, this one
comes back.
Back and down.
Right. So by doing this, you'll move them and kind of pull the strings taut a little bit, move them some more, and keep looking for that top wing to be like that. Another possibility is you can come in underneath and loosen the four screws that hold the bottom wing, and it enables the bottom wing to move ever so slightly.
Okay.
Okay. As you're working this, you keep pulling the strings taut, and I think we start here, of course, the initial one's here and it's glued, and we go up through here, and I pull here, and then I come up here and I pull here, and to keep it taut all the way across over here, and then what I will do with the string after it's kind of taut is I'll have somebody hold it over here while I do the other one.
Mm-hmm.
It takes two people to do it right. Call a buddy, have him come over, if your wife really loves you,
yeah,
she might be willing to help. If she's like my wife, she's been doing it for 23 years, she says, go find someone else.
Yeah, yeah.
And such. But
this is kind of like having your mom tie your shoelaces, right?
Right.
It's like the same sort of procedure.
Yeah, and such. So as we do that, we want to make sure we come in and we sight. The trailing edges match the leading edges, and one's not bent more. Then you come down to the bottom of the aircraft, and you do the same thing looking at the bottom wing.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? Now, with that, once those are done, I come over here, and what I sit down and do is I will come over the top of the airplane and try and sight down, looking at the trailing edge of the wing and where it causes the lower wing to disappear. You want those to be pretty much even.
Same place on both wings.
It should line up. Everything's been laser cut and tabbed. It should be very close. And if you're within an eighth of an inch, quarter of an inch, you're going to be fine. If you're off by 2 inches, then there's an issue. But for this airplane and the way it's designed to fly, as long as you're in the ballpark, we're not looking for dead precise stuff here. It's not necessary. It'll work very, very well.
Okay, so, well, this thing, yeah. I'm seeing what you mean there. Normally, all the rigging is just for looks on an airplane, but this one gives the modelers a little more chance to kind of fine-tune their airplane, learn a few things while they're doing it about lining up the flying surfaces and things. And you know, like you mentioned, the old three-flighter thing, we always, you know, you sight the airplane
right.
rather than measure it.
That's correct.
So it's amazing how close a human, you know, human can get something
yeah.
by just looking at it. So that's not something to be scared of. It's just
no.
another way.
It's a new form talent
new
for
form
some of these guys.
From
many years ago, we just brought it back.